Shall praise you. Your hand shall be on the neck of your enemies. Your father's sons shall bow down before you. Judah is a lion's cub. From the prey, my son, you have gone up. He crouches down. He stretches out like a lion, like a lioness. Who dares rouse him? The scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor the ruler's staff from between his feet, until tribute comes to him, and the obedience of the peoples is his. The word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
Justice and peace shall flourish forever.
Justice and peace shall flourish forever.
Give the king your justice, O God, and your righteousness to a king's son. May he judge your people with righteousness and your poor with justice.
Justice and peace shall flourish forever.
May the mountains yield prosperity for the people and the hills in righteousness. May he defend the cause of the poor of the people, give deliverance to the needy, and crush the oppressor.
Justice and peace shall flourish forever.
In his days, may righteousness flourish and peace abound until the moon is no more. May he have dominion from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth.
Justice and peace shall flourish forever.
May his name endure forever, his fame continue as long as the sun. May all nations be blessed in him. May they pronounce him happy.
Justice and peace shall flourish forever.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come, wisdom of our God Most High, guiding creation with power and love, teach us to walk in the path of knowledge.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
An account of the genealogy of Jesus, the Messiah, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Abraham was the father of Isaac. Isaac, the father of Jacob. Jacob, the father of Judah and his brothers. Judah, the father of Perez and Sarah by Tamar. Perez, the father of Hezron. Hezron, the father of Aram. Aram, the father of Aminadab. Aminadab, the father of Nahshon. Nahshon, the father of Salmon. Salmon, the father of Boaz by Rahab. Boaz, the father of Obed by Ruth. Obed, the father of Jesse. And Jesse, the father of King David. And David was the father of Solomon by the wife of Uriah. Solomon, the father of Rehoboam. Rehoboam, the father of Abijah. Abijah, the father of Asaph. Asaph, the father of Jehoshaphat. Jehoshaphat, the father of Joram. Joram, the father of Uzziah. Uzziah, the father of Jotham. Jotham, the father of Ahaz. Ahaz, the father of Hezekiah. Hezekiah, the father of Manasseh. Manasseh, the father of Amos. The father of Josiah. And Josiah, the father of Jeconiah and his brothers at the time of the deportation of Babylon. And after the deportation to Babylon, Jeconiah was the father of Salathiel. Salathiel, the father of Zerubbabel. Zerubbabel, the father of Abiud. Abiud, the father of Eliakim. Eliakim, the father of Asher. Asher, the father of Sadok. Sadok, the father of Ashim. Ashim, the father of Eliud. Eliud, the father of Eleazar. Eleazar, the father of Matthan. Matthan, the father of Jacob, and Jacob, the father of Joseph, the husband of Mary, of whom Jesus was born, who is called Messiah. So all the generation from Abraham to David are 14 generations, and from David to deportation of Babylon, 14 generations, and from the deportation to Babylon to the Messiah, 14 generations. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Today we begin the octave of Christmas, and the reading which we have today, and also in these 8 days we have readings in relationship to the birth of birth and childhood of Jesus. And today's reading, probably one of the strangest gospel readings we listen or in this childhood birth story. There are so many names which we may not be able to pronounce sometimes, but there is a theology of this genealogy. Saint Matthew has written this genealogy with a purpose. There are a lot of themes that we should understand in order to understand Jesus. First of all, we may ask why these names have to be there in the beginning of the Gospel of Matthew. So each of us are aware that the story of our ancestors is very important of our story. It is a part of our history, life history. And we know that part of story there is that is below the ground, and there is deep for a tree, there is a part, the root is below the ground. Just like that, it was clearly important for evangelist Matthew to communicate some sense of Jesus' family tree. So in Jesus' genealogical tree that Matthew gives us, there are a number of people who were anything but a paragon of virtue. We see a lot of holy people and people in virtue in this genealogy. At the same time, we can see many of them had what we would call today a dark side. Take the case of David and Tama. And some of them are not very famous, and some are famous, but some of them have a unclean or bad or life, we can see if you go through the history of their life. Yet Matthew is declaring that God worked through all these people, including those who character left a lot to be desired, to give the world, to give to the world this Savior. So Matthew's genealogy reminds us that in the words of Saint Paul, we can say, God's power can be made perfect in weakness. God never looks the weakness of these people, but God has to do something, and He has His pre-plan to save the world, and He takes His own way to fulfill His plan. And therefore, even when we are not our best, God's purpose for our lives and all the lives of others continues to work itself out. So what we must do? We must always surrender ourselves to the will of God. That's what we can do. Then we will experience the change in our life. Then we experience the transformation in our life. Then we can experience the God within us. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of our creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, the fruit of the earth, and work of human hands, which will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, the fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, your almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands to the praise and glory of his name. Our good and the good of all the holy church.
Sanctify these gifts of your church, O Lord, and grant that through these venerable mysteries we may be nourished with the bread of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him, with love beyond all tellings. John the Baptist said of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by this gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with the angels and archangels, the thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts of powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be borrowed from you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope Francis and our Bishop Christian and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, Lord, we pray. And with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have praised you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coronated to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teachings, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from our distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant that peace and unity in accordance with your will, we live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
To free your captive, hear.
Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Nourished by these divine gifts, Almighty God, we ask you to grant our desire that flame with your spirit, we may shine like bright torches before your Christ when he comes, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
As is ended, go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice and happy day.
What a